Good morning, everybody. We got another unseasonably warm day in Vermont. Perfect day to restore one of these guys. These are the two 1-ton axles I have for the Tacoma. This is a 14-bolt rear and a Dana 60 front, both out of a 1980-something Chevy. This one has, the 14-bolt has a Detroit locker, and the Dana 60 has a track lock, like a limited slip or something like that. They're both 456 or right about there, and they are beasts. Some of you keener Toyota guys out there will notice that, or say, hey Seth, what the hell are you doing? The differential's on the wrong side to go into a Tacoma. However, what I'm going to do is that thing is going to get a Toyota pickup transfer case. I'm going to get an adapter plate and put a geared transfer case on there, and then I can clock it to come out. I can clock it so the drive shaft comes out passenger instead of driver, so no worries there. But I think I'm going to take this 14 bolt out today and wire brush and get the rust off and the scale and prime and paint it. So just to give you guys a little background, this restoration is not going to be a full axle rebuild. I have no intentions of fully restoring these axles. I basically just want to get them looking good. Redo the seals and sling them under the truck and start thrashing. So I'm not trying to make a linked crawler that took me years to do. I just want to have some fun, but it doesn't mean the axles can't look good. So let's roll this thing out here and start tackling it. Sanding and wire brushing, and I'm going to put some rust converter on this thing on those few spots that looks like has a little more pitting. Adding a couple coats of this Rust-Oleum Steel Tech. It's supposed to be a cheaper version of this stuff, which I painted my bumper with, called Steel It. This is significantly more expensive. Used a little of it of this stuff so far, and it definitely doesn't look to be quite as high quality as the steelit, but it might be a good alternative. So I'm just adding a couple layers on the axle. It's a little too flashy for my taste to leave it as a top coat, so I'm just going to use it for corrosion protection and then put a coat of enamel black over top. Restoration. Just put the last coat of black enamel on there. Let me see if I can lower this thing. Show you what the front diff cover looks like. Go. Looks pretty slick, if I don't say so myself. Right now, I really don't care too much about the drum brakes, so I did wire brush them a little and gave them a coat of primer, a coat of paint, but that is by far the least work I did on this axle. However, the housing itself, I ground into pretty good, got into all the pitting I could, and I think it'll hold up, honestly. I also have to, this one has one cracked stud, so I didn't mess around too much with the hubs here. I'm just going to pound out that stud at a later time, put in another one, or just run seven, I don't know. But, yeah, I also didn't do much with the hubs. But, there you go, guys. Quick restoration on a 456 Detroit locked Chevy 14 bolt axle. If you liked the video, please actually like the video. Comment, tell me what you like, tell me what I could have done better. Make sure to subscribe because there's going to be a lot more with these axles coming up real soon.